Hello there, welcome to today's chemistry video. In this video, we will do a Cambridge IGCSE past paper together. This paper is the latest exam taken in February-March 2020 series, and it is paper 4, the theory paper. The first question here says, petroleum is a useful natural resource. The diagram shows how petroleum can be separated into useful substances. So we have a petroleum here and a list of products produced from this machine. So what is the name of the separation process shown in the diagram? Okay, this diagram is commonly used as an example of fractional distillation. So the answer for A is fractional distillation. Part B, they're asking the name of fractional leaving at A and B, so we're just supposed to keep the order in our minds. And A is between gasoline and kerosene. So the answer is going to be naphtha. And for B, it's the last one over here. And it's bitumen. Moving on, part C, refinery gas A is a mixture of hydrocarbons. One refinery gas is butane C4H10. Suggest the names of two other refinery gases. So the refinery gases they're talking about is over here. And one of the examples given here is butane. And the other two, we have methane and ethane. Or you could also write propane. Okay, write the chemical equation for the complete combustion of butane. So complete combustion is when there's enough oxygen for the combustion, and it's for butane. So butane is C4H10, and there's oxygen, and the product of complete combustion is always carbon dioxide and water. So you put carbon dioxide and water, and we have to balance this equation. So, let's just put a 2 over here, so you'll get C8 and H20, so if there are 8 carbons, this should be 8 over here, so you'll have 8 carbons, and over here it was 20 hydrogens, so over here it should be 10 hydrogens, so in total over here there are 26 oxygens, so this should be 13 oxygens on the left. So you balance it and we're done. And then name the toxic gas produced by the incomplete combustion of butane. So it doesn't really matter if it's butane or a methane. If it's incomplete combustion, the answer is always carbon monoxide. Part D, gasoline and kerosene are both fuels. They have different properties. Describe the differences in the properties given. Right, so let's see where gasoline and kerosene are. Gasoline's on top, kerosene's two steps below. So from here we can see that gasoline is lighter than kerosene because it's above it and it had the ability to be above kerosene because it's lighter. So the viscosity, we can say that kerosene is more viscous. This is because kerosene is below gasoline in the list. And flammability, we can say that gasoline is more flammable. And what difference in the molecules of gasoline and kerosene causes these differences in properties? So just as I mentioned, whatever's on top or below, that's what it matters. And to be on top or below something, what matters is your relative molecular mass. And that is related to the length of carbon chain. So you can say kerosene has molecules with a longer carbon chain. So basically, kerosene's relative molecular mass is bigger, so it's heavier, so it's below gasoline, so it's more viscous and less flammable. Okay, part E, hydrogen fuel cells can be used to power vehicles. Write the word equation for the overall reaction that takes place in a hydrogen fuel cell. So if it's a hydrogen fuel cell, this is a fixed equation as well. It's hydrogen plus oxygen giving water. Okay, that's the end for question 1. Question 2. Aluminium is extracted from its ore. The ore is converted into pure aluminium oxide, which then undergoes electrolysis as shown. So this diagram appears when we learn about the extraction of aluminium. And the question says, name an ore of aluminium. So where's the source of the aluminium? What's the source of it? That is bauxite. And what is meant by the term electrolysis? So we're just supposed to memorize this definition, which is break down by electricity of an ionic compound in molten state. Next, aluminium oxide has a melting point about 2000 degrees Celsius, but the electrolysis process operates at about 900 degrees Celsius. So you can see that the melting point has decreased. And it says, name the compound added to it, aluminium oxide, to reduce the operating temperature. So this is also one of the popular questions. It's cryolite. This helps to decrease the melting point. Okay, suggest one benefit to the environment of reducing the operating temperature. So there is this environmental benefit and this industrial benefit. And the environmental benefit is that it reduces the carbon dioxide emission. You need less heat to reach its melting point. So less heat is produced, I mean less heat is introduced. So less carbon dioxide is produced. Write the ionic half equation for the reaction taking place at the negative electrode cathode and the positive electrode anode. So the cathode is over here and the anode is here. Okay, so since the cathode is the negative electrode, it's gonna attract the positive ions. So the positive ions in this aluminium oxide is Al3+, and it's the half equation, so Al3+ will need to have 3 electrons because it's 3 positive, and it's going to give you Al, an atom, and it's a positive electron for anode, so it's going to attract negative ions. So a negative ion is O, and O is 2 minus. And then it's a half equation, so in the end it's supposed to produce O2 oxygen and 2 electrons. And you can see that it's O2, so this O2 minus needs to have a 2 in front to balance it. Right, lastly, explain the anodes need frequent replacements. So why does it need frequent replacement? So if you look at anodes here, it's this guy's, and this guy's need to be changed. And the answer is actually right here. Oxygen is produced, and you know that anodes are made of carbon. So carbon's gonna react with oxygen and start forming carbon dioxide. So the answer is, anodes react with oxygen and form carbon dioxide. And if you ask why is producing carbon dioxide a problem, It's because carbon dioxide is acidic and it can corrode the anode, but you don't need to write it for the answer. Part C, aluminium oxide reacts with acids and with alkalis. What term is used to describe an oxide that reacts with acids and with alkalis? That's as simple, it's amphoteric. Aluminium oxide reacts with dilute sulfuric acid to form a salt. State the name and write the formula of the salt formed. So aluminium oxide, this is just Al2O3 made by Al3 plus ion and O2 minus ion, and dilute sulfuric acid is H2SO4 made of H plus ion and SO4 2 minus ion. So now to find the formula of the salt, we just need to add the cation part and the anion part of the acid, so that's just Al2SO4 3. So formula is going to be Al2SO4 3, and the name of this compound is aluminium sulfate. Part 3, aluminium oxide reacts with dilute sodium hydroxide to form a salt and one other product. Name the other product. So when aluminium oxide and dilute sodium hydroxide react together, they're going to form something called sodium aluminate as a salt. And the other product's going to be just water. Part 4, aluminium hydroxide ALOH3 decomposes when heated to form aluminium oxide and water. So write the chemical equation for this reaction. So it's pretty simple. The answer is already given in the question. ALOH3 gives you aluminium oxide and water. So ALOH3 decomposes to give aluminium oxide, which is Al2O3, and water. So we just need to balance it. There are two aluminium here, so we put two. And this is gonna give you six hydrogens. So we need to put three over here to balance it. And yep, it's balanced. Last one, suggest the names of two other aluminium compounds that decompose when heated to form aluminium oxide. So we've learned this in the decomposition of the compounds. Which one produces the compound with oxide? So it's pretty simple. It's either a carbonate compound or a nitrate compound. So we can write aluminium carbonate and aluminium nitrate. I'll cover the next three questions in my next video because I don't want this video to be too long. So check my next video out and thank you for watching. Please subscribe to my channel for more videos like this. Stay safe and God bless you guys. Bye.